भैया वीडियो हटालो, नहीं तो कभी कभार अटेंडी आ जाते हैं, हम बनियान पहने आराम से बैठे हैं।
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू, अ वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड रिसोर्स पर्सन डॉक्टर संसनवाल सर, बिहाफ ऑफ कल्याण पीजी कॉलेज। टुडेज टॉपिक इज मल्टीपल कोरिलेशन। आई एम इनवाइटिंग टू रिस्पेक्टेड संसनवाल सर टू गिव गाइडेंस एंड लेक्चर अबाउट मल्टीपल कोरिलेशन। वेलकम सर।
All right. Thank you very much.
थैंक यू सर।
Dear friends, as far as the correlation is concerned, I have already talked about the correlation and I have talked about the different methods of computing correlation. And I have told you that other methods of the where the correlation will be used, your variables must be continuous variable, but you have seen that biserial correlation and point biserial correlation, in these one variable was continuous and another was discrete. Okay, but yesterday I talked about partial correlation. Now there all variables must be continuous variable. Now, taking that further, today I will talk about another technique which is very important, although all techniques are important, and now I will talk about multiple correlation. You know, this particular technique, it really requires the data of a very, very special nature. And what is that? Let me tell you the assumptions. Now, one assumption is that there must be minimum three variables all variables must be continuous. Must be continuous or have scale of measurement or have interval or ratio scale of measurement. So this is the one important thing. If you do not have three variables, then you cannot compute multiple correlation. Then another is all variables must have normal distribution. Okay, of course, there should be no outliers. Okay, now these are the assumptions. let me tell you what exactly is the concept of the multiple correlation. Concept of multiple correlation. See, all of you know it very well that if suppose someone is having a BP, he is suffering from blood pressure, and when he goes to the doctor, doctor examines and doctor immediately tells him that you should reduce your salt intake. Salt intake. Why? Because the salt intake is related with the blood pressure. If you take more salt, your blood pressure is likely to increase. Another is the stress. If you have more stress, then your BP is likely to increase. Then your daily routine, unhealthy routine. Unhealthy routine. If you do not have very active life, then of course, and if you do not eat a balanced food, all these type of the thing, these three together will be responsible for your BP. Another can be that the job which you are doing, the job profile may also help. You know, there are some job which are very, very taxing job. So something like this, all these variables are, all these variables are related with the BP. So that means if you want the multiple correlation, you must have minimum three variables so that you can find out the joint contribution. You know, you cannot take out stress from your personality. It is a part and parcel of your personality. You cannot take out your routine activities. It's a part of your personality. It has to be there. You cannot take out salt, because whatever you eat, in some of the things you have the salt. So like this, there are many factors which are related with the blood pressure. So therefore, as a researcher, you may like to study the joint contribution of salt intake, stress, unhealthy routines, job profile, etc., in predicting the BP. Okay, so it has to be a joint contribution. Suppose you take the achievement. Say achievement in mathematics. And you know, achievement in mathematics, the variables related are, say, your reasoning. Reasoning is related with achievement. Your study habits, it is related with achievement in mathematics, your interest is related with the achievement in mathematics. So therefore, these three and many other, these variables put together will be responsible for your achievement in mathematics. If you have good reasoning, if you have better study habit, if you have interest in mathematics, then your achievement in mathematics is likely to be better. So therefore, there will be a joint contribution of reasoning, study habits, and interest in predicting achievement in mathematics. Okay? So if suppose I say that this achievement in mathematics, if I represent by 1, and reasoning, if I represent by 2, and study habit, I represent by 3, and interest, if I represent by 4, then I can represent R. Multiple correlation is denoted by capital R. The small r does not represent the multiple correlation, that represents only the correlation. So therefore, it has to be capital R, and you want to predict achievement in mathematics. So it is 1, because this is the achievement, and then it is 2, 3, and 4. Now the meaning is the joint effect of variable 2, variable 3, and variable 4 in predicting variable 1. Now if suppose I write something like this, if I say here, let us say 4, and if I say here, let us say 1. If I say 4 and in the bracket 1, 2, 3, that means the joint contribution of variable 1, variable 2, and variable 3 in predicting variable 4. I hope you have understood. So it means, let me write here so that you can understand it. It means that the joint contribution of reasoning, joint contribution of reasoning, comma, study habit, and interest in predicting achievement in mathematics. In mathematics of students. That is the meaning of R, 1, and in the bracket 2, 3, 4. So you must understand the symbol which we are using in order to indicate the multiple correlation. I hope you have understood it. But if suppose you want this, the meaning is it shows that the joint contribution joint contribution of reasoning, study habits, of reasoning, study habits, and achievement in mathematics. And achievement in mathematics in predicting interest of students. So this is what exactly the meaning. So therefore, the general formula, you can write something like this. Then you can write here, so in multiple correlation, you can take as many variables as you like. There is no limit, but only important is whatever the assumptions I have just now given, the variables must fulfill those assumptions. And if you have a variable which does not fulfill the assumption, then you cannot analyze the data with the help of multiple correlation. Now, this multiple correlation is very important. And you know, whenever the metrological people, they do the forecasting. What metrological people do during raining season, they predict that there will be heavy rains at these places, or they predict that there will be a dust storm and at these places. There will be cold air at this places with this temperature. This is what they are forecasting. And when they are forecasting, they are using different variables for prediction purpose. So forecasting and prediction both are same. So you can use these words interchangeably, no problem. So therefore, when the meteorological department, they forecast that this will be the speed, this will be the dust storm, or this will be the rain, or etc. They take parameters like wind, the speed of the wind, they take the moisture content, they take their other parameters also. And they have already establish these equations, and they can always use these equations for prediction purposes, which I will tell you tomorrow when I talk about regression equation or regression analysis. Regression analysis is the name of the statistical technique. And for predictions, you have to establish what they call it a regression equation. That I will tell you tomorrow. So today I am just limiting to the joint contribution whenever we are trying to understand. You know, what is the personality of any person? Your personality is not governed by one of your ability. No, it is governed by many of your abilities put together. And that is why sometimes personality is defined as a multi-factor type of thing. And it is the interaction that keeps on happening between different your characteristics. So it is your joint contribution of your different characteristics that will reflect your personality. You know, some people, when you look at it, they seem to be very confident. But when you start asking questions, then you start feeling that now the confidence which they were exhibiting earlier has come down. Why? Because it is not only your confidence. You get confidence when you understand certain things. And if you do not understand, then maybe you are, that is why sometimes we say such and such person is overconfident. You know, you exhibit so much confidence that as you know everything. So like this, there are large number of applications of multiple correlation. In medical science, it has lot of implications, or you can say applications. In sciences also, it has applications. You can use it in different areas, wherever you have different variables on the basis of which you want to find the joint contribution, then you can use it. Let me take these variables and let me write the objective. How exactly I will be writing the objective? Let me take these three variables. I'm taking these three variables and I am writing the objectives. Now I am writing objectives. I think this is 14th, most probably. Yes, this is 14th. The 14th objective is to study. You cannot say to find out. You cannot say to examine. You cannot say to evaluate. So you have to say to study the joint contribution. Joint contribution of reasoning. Joint contribution of reasoning and study habits. Reasoning and study habits in predicting. In predicting achievement in mathematics of students. Achievement in mathematics of students. Now this should be the wording of the objective. And if this is the wording of the objective, then you cannot analyze your data with the help of any statistical technique you like, but you have to use multiple correlation. So I have been giving every day the example of the objective, and then I'm saying if this is the wording, then this is the only statistical technique that you can use, provided the assumptions are satisfied by the data. And that is why I have been telling you the assumptions before I explain you that particular statistical technique. And now if this is my objective, then how do I write my hypothesis? Now, I am sure you can write it yourself. So I'm giving you 2 minutes to write the hypothesis for it. and then you can compare the wording of your hypothesis with the wording of my hypothesis. And if your wording resembles my wording, then congratulations to you because you have understood it. And hats off to you. So write the hypothesis. I'm sure you have written it. So now you can compare the wording of your hypothesis with the wording of my hypothesis. It starts like this. There is no significant joint contribution of reasoning study habits in predicting achievement in mathematics of students. I'm sorry, let us write in why I did not write in here. So achievement in mathematics. All right. So therefore, that is what is the hypothesis. Now, once you have the hypothesis, now let me go to my SPSS and then I have to have the information about variables like reasoning, like study habit, and like the achievement in mathematics. Now, dear friends, if suppose you have the male and female, and you want to take that variable also, and you want to use the multiple correlation technique to analyze the data of male students and the female students, then how do I write my objective? That my objective should be written something like this. Objective 15. Can be written like this: to study the joint contribution of reasoning and study habits in predicting achievement in mathematics of male and female students separately. Because male and female are the two levels of gender, and gender is a discontinuous variable. So you can analyze the data by taking male separately and female separately, absolutely no problem. And if that be so, then your hypothesis will be something like this. So I'm copying and paste and then making the changes here. Your 15 hypothesis will be, there is no significant joint contribution of reasoning and study habits in predicting achievement in mathematics of male and female students separately. Now, similarly, if you wanted for partial correlation also, for male and female, you have to write male and female separately. If you want to have students belonging to the government schools and the private schools. Then you can say to study the joint contribution of reasoning and study habits in predicting achievement in mathematics of students studying in government schools and private schools separately. Well, that's what you can do. It's absolutely no problem. If suppose you want that male students studying in government and private schools, then you can write to study the joint contribution of reasoning and study habits in predicting achievement in mathematics of male students studying in government schools and private schools separately. And then you have to write another one for female. So this is how you can keep on writing, and then you can keep on analyzing your data and then keep on publishing paper. My dear friends, once you collect the data, the same data can be analyzed by using different statistical techniques. But which statistical technique you want to use will be decided by the wording of your objective. And once you have collected the data, so the same data you keep on analyzing differently. And from same data, you keep on extracting different informations. Most of the people, they collect a lot of data and they do not really take out the complete information out of it. So a lot of information, it is wasted. Okay, so let me write, if you like, I can write that we just now said, male students studying in government schools and private schools. Like that, if you want male rural student, that also can be done, no problem at all. Then you can say to study the joint contribution of reasoning and study habits in predicting achievement in mathematics of urban male students studying in government schools and private schools separately, because all these are male from the urban area. So this is constant, because you have not taken male from the rural area. It's only male from urban area. You have not taken female from urban. It's only male from urban area. You know, like this. So you can keep on going. You are intelligent people. Okay. Now, let me go to my SPSS. So what I will take is, I will take these two, this objective and this hypothesis. So therefore, I'm just copying it and I want to just put it here so that you understand. So this is the 14th. So in this, my variables are reasoning, study habits, and achievement in mathematics. Okay. So now let me go to my SPSS. So this is my SPSS. Okay. I share it with you. Now, I hope you are able to see this particular page. Now, as we have been doing, we should first go to the variable view and we should list all the variables whose data we have collected. So we have collected the data of reasoning. It is a continuous variable. Another is study habit. Continuous variable. Another is achievement in mathematics. These are the three. Okay. Now, if you want gender also, so that I can tell you how will you analyze your data separately for male and female. Now, gender has got two levels, and these are, one is male, and two is females. Okay, all right, let's see. Now here, I enter the data of the reasoning. So let me just enter the data of the reasoning. Suppose I have this much data, nothing to worry. Okay, now I put the study habit scores also. So if you have your SPSS, so you can keep on doing along with me. Now you put your achievement in mathematics. Okay, you have entered the data. Let me enter the data of the gender also. Okay, I've entered the data. Now, let me go to my analyze. I go to analyze, click it here, and I'm sure you can find the, this is correlate, and here you do not have a icon which is multiple correlation. You know, multiple correlation, you note it down. Multiple correlation is inbuilt in the regression analysis. So for multiple correlation and for regression, you should go to regression. And once you go to regression, you go to linear, because the assumption is all these variables, they are linearly related. They do not have curvy linear relationship, but they have linear relationship. So that we can write another assumptions in the objectives, no problem. So I go to the linear and I click here. Now here, which variable am I trying to study the contribution to? It is the achievement in mathematics. So this becomes, they have written a dependent, but these words dependent and independent, you should use only in case of experimental study. Now, I want the joint contribution of reasoning and study habit that I shift in the independent. So you should understand which variable you should shift where. And at present, I am not bothering about gender. Okay, all right. Let us go to option. Now option is that, all right, it is 0.01, no problem, 0.05, no problem. Now the plot, no, I don't want to plot anything, then statistics. Now, these are predefined estimates and model fit. These are automatically highlighted. So you need not to bother about it. It's okay. Now you want R square change. So click it here. Okay. You want R square. So click it here. If you want descriptives, you can click it here. And if you want part correlation and partial correlation, then you can click it here. Okay. So we can click it here and then we say continue. And then we say continue. Now see, you have got here. What are the things that you are getting here? Say you have achievement in mathematics. How many students? 30 students. What is the mean? 30.60. What is the mean of the reasoning? 29.83. What the mean of the study habit? 28.33. And these are the standard deviation, and everywhere you have 30 people. Now, see the correlation, the achievement in mathematics and reasoning. This is the correlation 0.139. The achievement in study habit is 0.53, 0.053. So these are the correlations you have got. Okay, we go ahead. Now this is what exactly the two one you should have. One is a model summary. Here, model one, this is capital R. And capital R is multiple correlation. And the multiple correlation value is 0.149. It is 0.149. Now, whether this value is significant or not, in this one, you see at the end, it is written significant. And the error is 0.739 multiplied by 100. So it is 73.9% error is there. Okay. So that means this multiple correlation value is not significant. I hope you have understood it. Okay. And when it is not significant, now this is R square. This R square is 0.022. And if you multiply it by 100, then it will come to 2.20%. So that means the joint contribution of study habit and reasoning in predicting achievement in mathematics is only 2.20%. So 2% is no percent. So therefore it's insignificant contribution. Okay, so let us see how do I take these values and then how do I test my hypothesis. Now, before I proceed, let me tell you the other thing. Suppose you want this analysis only for male. So what do? We go to data. We go to select cases. And then we should highlight if condition is satisfied, you click it here. And then you click it here. And you want to segregate or you want to divide the data on the basis of gender, and you want gender is equal to one, and one means males. So you will get the data of the male. So now here, the data will be filtered. And when you are doing the filtering, if you want male, then you only get the male data. The female data, you cannot use, it will filter out. So I say continue, I say continue. So the filter is over. And now I say analyze, I say regression, linear, and this I say okay. Now say, this is what you have. Oh, okay. There are 15 males are there, and you see the multiple correlation is exactly the same, almost the same. Okay. So let us see for the, in case of female, what happens. So if condition instead of one, now I write two. So the data will be only of the females. And now I analyze regression linear and I say, okay. So you have the data of the females. And here, you see this, your multiple correlation value has changed here. Now here, multiple correlation value is 0.264. Earlier it was 0.14 something. And now the joint contribution is 7%. Earlier it was 2%. Okay. In male also it was 2%. So here it is, but it is not significant. So like this, if you like, you can filter your data. Absolutely no problem. Okay. All right. So let us take down the values here so that I make a table and I explain you. Okay, this was the my data. So that means my multiple correlation value is 0.149. So I can say 0.15. And it is not significant. Okay. So therefore, now I am going to share and I go here. Now, you know the objective, you know. Now, let us see how do I make the heading. So it is 14.1.0. Now think of what can be the heading. Yes, the heading will be joint contribution. Joint contribution of reasoning. Okay. Reasoning and study habit. And study habits in predicting. In predicting achievement in mathematics. Achievement in mathematics of students. Now, this is the heading which you have written. on the basis of the wording of the objectives. So dear friends, if your objective wording is pinpointed, then writing the caption heading is not at all a problem. It becomes problem only when you have not written the wording of your objective pinpointedly. So therefore, this is, now let us see now. So I can copy and say the 14th objective. Was to study the joint contribution of reasoning and study habits in predicting achievement in mathematics of students. Okay, the data were analyzed with the help of multiple correlation. You cannot write regression analysis. The statisticians, they have merged the multiple correlation along with the regression, because when you compute regression, then you do require the multiple correlation value. So that is why they have done that. So, but you have to write with the help of multiple correlation and the results are given in table 14. So here I can write table 14. Okay. And then here, let me insert the table 14. Okay, let me insert the table 14. Suppose I only want to have two, and this is all right. Now, here I say variable, and here I say capital R. And my variables are like this. One is reasoning. You can number them in any way you like, no problem. Next is study habits. And the next is achievement in mathematics. Okay, then what is this R? This R, you have to write something like this, because you are predicting achievement in mathematics, and achievement is denoted by 3. So 3, then in the bracket, you should write 1, 2, and bracket close. So this is what means the joint contribution of variable 1 and variable 2 in predicting variable 3. And here, the value which I have got is 0.15. And it is not significant. Okay. So here I'll say the multiple correlation multiple correlation coefficient in predicting in predicting achievement in mathematics, achievement in mathematics, on the basis of reasoning and study habits of students. Okay. So this is the heading of this particular table. Then we can say from table 14, it can be seen that the multiple correlation coefficient, I'm just copying, that it can be seen that the multiple It can be seen that the multiple correlation coefficient, it can be seen that the multiple correlation coefficient is 0.15, which is not significant. Okay, it indicates that it indicates that there is no significant joint contribution, of reasoning and study habit of students in predicting their achievement in mathematics. Thus, the null hypothesis that now you can copy your hypothesis. The null hypothesis that there is no significant joint contribution of reasoning and study habit in predicting achievement in mathematics of students is not rejected. Now, once I write is not rejected, as I have been telling you every day, this is what is called testing of a hypothesis. So testing of a hypothesis is a part and parcel of your interpretation. If you are not able to really write your interpretation properly, then it is your fault that you are not able to test your hypothesis. So otherwise, it's very easy. Okay. Now, since there is no joint contribution, so therefore you can say it may therefore be said that achievement in mathematics, it may therefore be said that achievement in mathematics of students cannot be predicted on the basis of, or you can say, it may therefore be said that reasoning and study habit were not found to be, okay, I think that's a better one. I can write like this. It may therefore be said that reasoning and study habits were not found to be significant predictors of achievement in mathematics of students. Or you can say achievement in mathematics of students cannot be predicted on the basis of reasoning and study habit of student. Whatever you like, that's fine, nice. So this is how the interpretation is over, and this becomes your finding. So if you move systematically, then writing the finding is not a very, very difficult task. It is very easy task. Okay, all right. Let me take another example where I think the value may come out to be significant. Then how do we write that? So let me now share the SPSS. So I am sharing my SPSS. I'm going here. Okay, now let me take another file. I'm opening the data, whatever the data I have. And let me see which data do I take. Okay. Let us see which one. Okay, let me see this data. All right, I'm opening this data. Say suppose here, if I have the self-efficacy, emotional competence, and then another, I'm saying, okay, self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience. These are the three variables I'm taking in predicting burnout. Okay, and this is the data of the teachers. So therefore, I go to analyze and I go to regression. And then I want to predict the dependent is this. And then I can select these and I'm putting it here. Okay, now go to statistics. You want R square. You want descriptive, you want this, you can take all, no problem. And that's your result. Now let me see what is my capital R. Now see, my capital R here, just see, my capital R value is, see, 0.979. So I can say 0.98, 0.979, and 0.979 means 0.98. And here R square is 0.958. So I can say 0.96. And this 0.96 multiplied by 100, it becomes 96%. So that means your joint contribution is 95.8%. And this contribution is significant. You can see here 0.000. Okay, why such a result you have got it? You see the
sir, आपकी, excuse me, sir.
हाँ बोलो
सर आपकी स्क्रीन नहीं दिख रही
नहीं दिख रही All right. So let me go again. अभी दिख रही है
नहीं सर
अरे कैसे नहीं नहीं दिख रही
नहीं सर नहीं दिख रही है
माय गॉड यार
आप सर दिख रहे हैं
अरे दिख तो रही है भाई
अरे सर दिखने लगी है अभी दिख रही
है ओके ऑल राइट लेट मी शेयर इट अगेन इज इट अवेलेबल इट्स ओके नाउ
Yes, sir.
All right. So therefore, I was talking about the joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out. The multiple correlation is 0.979. And the percentage contribution is 95.8%. Just see, these three variables, they contribute in predicting burnt out to the extent of 96% or 95.8%, which is very high. And you see, this value is significant. In the last, you can say it is 0.000. So that means this multiple correlation is significant and it is significant at 0.01 level because it is 0.000. Then we can write 0.01. And this value you have got from here, ANOVA. Okay, now, because this multiple correlation value is very high. And these three variables, they are contributing in prediction of burnt out. So let me show you the correlation among these variables. This is the correlation. You see the correlation between burnt out and self-efficacy. It is minus 0.976, such a high correlation. Burnt out and emotional competence, it is 0.657, it is high correlation. And burnt out with resilience, it is 0.919. So that is why I said in the assumption, those variables which you are taking, they must have high correlation among themselves. If they do not have the high correlation, then they cannot predict. Then they cannot predict the other variable. Now, since burnt out has got high correlation with self-efficacy, with emotional competence, and with resilience, that is why these three variables are contributing maximum in prediction of the burnt out. Okay, now let me see how to represent this particular data and how will I test my hypothesis. And I have to write objective. I have not written objective. So let me go to my, again, the sheet. And this is my, okay. So now let me write the objective. And I think this objective, what I'm writing is 50. And the objective is to study the joint contribution, of self-efficacy emotional competence and resilience in predicting burnt out of teachers, because this is the teachers' data. So I can write my hypothesis, and my hypothesis is 15th, there is no significant joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of teachers. Okay, now let us see how do I write my caption. It is 15.1.0. Now I say joint contribution of self-efficacy, comma, emotional competence, and resilience, in predicting burned out of teachers. Okay. Now, so therefore you say the 15th objective was to study the joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of teachers. Then you see the data were analyzed. With the help of multiple correlations. And the results are given in table 50. So I'll say table 15. And let me insert the table here. Okay, I can say here 3 and this and this. Okay, one is variable. Then another is my capital R. And then another is my remark. Now here, my one variable is self-efficacy. My second variable is emotional competence. And the third variable is resilience, and my fourth is burnt out. Let me take it on the next page. As far as possible, do not bifurcate the table. It must come all at one particular place. Then burnt out. Okay. And my this correlation value is 0.98. And this is significant at 0.01. And this I should say P. And here I should write that it is 4, then bracket 1, 2, 3, and bracket closed. That means the joint contribution of variable 1, variable 2, and variable 3 in predicting variable 4. If you want, you can write burned out in the beginning. It does not make a difference. You can put in any way you like. Okay. Now here it is multiple correlation coefficient. Multiple correlation coefficient. Of burned out. Let me copy what I wrote here so that I can make the changes. So I say like this. So let me just make changes. The multiple correlation coefficient in predicting burnt out. Burnt out on the basis of self-efficacy. On the basis of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience of teachers. Of teachers. Okay. Now, from table 15, it can be seen that the multiple correlation. That multiple correlation coefficient is 0.98, which is which is significant at 0.01 level. Okay, now if you want to write the here the degree of freedom, then you have to go back and then you have to write it is here. It is 3/296. It is 3/296. I will tell you about it, no problem at all. So level with DF equal to 3/296. From where did I get? It is from ANOVA. I showed you that ANOVA, so it was from there. Now this is the first sentence. So it reflects, if it reflects that self-efficacy, it reflects that there was a significant joint contribution of, let me copy these values from here, joint contribution of so it reflects that there was a joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of teachers. And this is because my multiple correlation coefficient is significant. If it would not have been significant, then I would not have written like this. Okay? All right. So thus, the null hypothesis that there is no significant, that there is no significant joint contribution, a no significant joint contribution of there is no significant joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of teacher is rejected. So once I write is rejected, so that means I have already tested my hypothesis. So I have tested my hypothesis. This is what exactly is the testing of a hypothesis. Okay, now because my multiple correlation coefficient is significant, now I should talk about what is the percentage joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience. Okay, so then we say further, the percentage, of joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, emotional competence and resilience. Further, the percentage of joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence and resilience in predicting burnt out of teachers is 95.8. Or you can say like this, further, the joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of teacher is 95.8%. So I can take out the percentage here. So further, the joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnout of teachers is 95.8%. Okay, which is quite high and significant. It may therefore be said that the self-efficacy burnout of teachers can but it may therefore be said that let us say it may therefore be said that self-efficacy, emotional competence and resilience were found to be the best were found to be the best and significant predictors significant predictors of burnout of teachers. So dear friends, now if you just copy and paste here, this becomes your finding. So if you want to find out the joint contribution, so this is how you can do in science. This particular statistical technique is very important. In medical science, it's very important. In pure science, it is very important. There are some areas of the social science where this technique is very, very, very important. So therefore, I have taken the example. Now, if you want, let me do the analysis and for male separately and female separately, and then let us see what is the result. Because I still have time. So let me write another objective. So I am writing the, I have already written. I'll just take that objective. Okay, this was the objective which I wrote. Okay, I think I should write it once again here. I write here. I'm taking and writing the objective. So let me say objective 16. I'm saying to study the joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of male and female teachers separately. Please do not forget to write the word separately. And then my hypothesis becomes, I can copy this and I write my hypothesis. The hypothesis 16 will be, there is no significant joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of male and female teachers separately. So let me go to my data sheet. So I'm sharing it. And this is my data sheet. Now you know that I have the male and female. So I first go to my data and I go to my select cases, because I want to select only males first or females first and then male second, no problem. So I go to data and go to the select cases, and then I highlight if condition is satisfied, then I click it here. I shift gender on this side and I say is equal to 1. 1 denotes the males. So therefore, whatever data I have, this will be the data only of males. Okay, so I have got the data of the males. You can see only the male. The female has been filtered out. Okay, and now I do my analysis. I go to regression and I go to linear. The burned out, everything is same. Now, this is the data, the findings you have got. Now, please, Shubham, are you able to see this output?
Yes, sir.
All right. So here, the multiple correlation value is 0.98. So I say 0.9, and here R square is 96.5%. Okay, and this is significant. Either you can see here or you can see under ANOVA. And it is significant at 0.01%. And this is the result in case of male. And the degree of freedom is 3/146. So this is the DF for the male. Now I go to the females and let me first go to data. I select cases and I, instead of 1, I say 2. Okay, and I continue. Now I again do the analysis, regression, linear, and this is the output. Now this is the multiple correlation. It is 90, it is 0.975. So 0.97, and here this R square is 95.1%. And this value is significant, 0.01, and the DF 3/146. Now you can see that for male and female, this multiple correlation is high and it is significant. So therefore, the results which you have to interpret is exactly the same which I have interpreted by taking both, and then the same you can change and you can write the interpretation for male and for females. So let me tell you how to write. So let us see, I'm sharing my this one. Okay, now you know this is what I wrote. So now I have to write join, and this will be 16.1.0, and I say joint contribution of self-efficacy comma emotional competence and resilience joint contribution of this in predicting burnt out of male, burnout of male and female teachers separately. Now I can copy this one. This my objective. So now I am writing. The 16th objective was to study the joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of male and female teachers separately. The data were analyzed with the help of multiple correlation. The data were analyzed separately. Separately with the help of multiple correlation and the results are given in table 16. If you want to write separately, you can write. Otherwise, one table will be quite all right. So table 16. Now let me insert the table here. So I'm inserting the table. And here, I'll first say gender. Because I have the male and I have the female. So I have to write their data separately, then variable. Then it is capital R. Then it is remark. And then next, this I can delete this one. Okay, now here I say, if you like, you can say male. And then here I can write the variable. If you like, I can save time. I can copy whatever I wrote in the earlier one. And these are the variables which I wrote here, so I can copy them. And here I can paste them. And this is the fourth one. All right. Then I can have another one, which is females. And now here I can again copy them. And this is the fourth one. Okay. And this one is the multiple correlation. In case of male, it was 0.98. In case of female, it was 0.97. And this was the 0.01. So here also P is less than 0.01. And again, I am requesting, please make this P small, because in statistics, the symbols are very important. If you, instead of small, if you write capital, it may denote something very different, okay? So therefore, this is what you have. Now here, we can write R. So I can say, because it is 4, so bracket 1, 2, 3, and bracket close. Okay? And now you can see, I can copy this title so that I can save time. So I'm copying this. So I can write this multiple correlation coefficients. I have to write because it is not one, you have the two. So multiple coefficients in predicting burnt out on the basis of self-efficacy and emotional competence and resilience of male and female teachers separately. Because you have entered the data separately. Okay. And now if I copy the interpretation also, so I will just change the interpretation and that will be quite all right. So let me take this interpretation and I will just, this is how you can save many a times the time you can save. Now here you have to make appropriate changes. So from table 16, it can be seen that the multiple correlation coefficient for males is 0.98, which is significant at 0.01 level with the DF equal to 3/146. Okay, so whatever the change that has to be made, it reflects that there was a significant joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of male teachers. Thus, the null hypothesis that there is no significant joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of male teachers is rejected. Further, the joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of male teachers is 96.50. So this is 96 and this is 5. Okay, but which is quite high. It may therefore be said that self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience were found to be the best and significant predictor or burnt out of male teachers. Now, similarly, you can copy and you can make the appropriate changes here. So let me just make appropriate changes here. Say from table, it can be seen that the multiple correlation coefficient for female. Okay, I did not write teachers. I think I should write female teachers. Here I should write male teachers. That's much better. So I can write here that the female teachers is 0.97. So it is, I have to make change, 97, which is significant at 0.01 level with the DF equal to 3/146. It reflects that there was a significant joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of female teachers. Thus, the null hypothesis that there is no significant joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of female teachers. Of female teachers is rejected. Further, the joint contribution of self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience in predicting burnt out of female teachers age, it is 95.1%. So I'll say 95, and this I'll say 1%, which is quite high and significant. It may therefore be said that self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience were found to be the best predictor, best and significant predictors of burnt out of female teachers. And if you want to write a finding, then you can write something like this. I tell you the finding which you have to write. So the finding becomes, I can write one finding that self-efficacy, emotional competence, and resilience were found to be the best and significant predictors of burnt out of male as well as female teachers. So you can write your finding something like this. So dear friends, I have taken another example and therefore I have demonstrated it to you. If you have another discontinuous variable and if you want to do the regression analysis, for that you can do, or multiple correlation coefficient you can compute. So now I over to the organizers if there are questions. So let me take the questions. I do not think there are many questions, but whatever the questions are there. So let us see what the questions. The number one question is, sir, in multiple correlation, does predicting and correlation mean one and the same? Please understand, you cannot calculate correlation mean. Please understand, correlation is a different technique, and correlation tells you the commonness. Mean does not tell you the commonness. Mean is another statistical technique, and you cannot calculate the correlation mean. So therefore, this is not the same. Multiple correlation means the joint contribution. So they are not the same thing. All right, next question is, sir, please check gender data again. It has been as 1-2. Okay, don't worry. If it is 1-2, you can change that, no problem. Okay, next question is, sir, correlation is for studying commonness, then the multiple correlation, then in multiple correlation, how we are using it for making prediction? Because multiple correlation concept, I have told you, it tells you the joint contribution. So multiple correlation will tell you the joint contribution. And I have given many examples in the BP. There is a joint contribution of your stress, of your salt intake, of your, say, your daily routine. All these, they jointly contribute, not separately. So they are jointly contributing, and therefore you can definitely write that. There is no harm. As far as I read, prediction can only be one using regression. No. Regression will tell you further. It will tell the individual contribution also, and it will give you the regression equation for predicting. It is the joint contribution. If there is no joint contribution, what are you predicting? So therefore, that's all right. So make a correction in your understanding. Okay, another is, how to decide about where to use one tail and two tail? Please wait. You have to attend another series of my lectures where I will talk about one tail test, two tail test, type one error, type two error, the different types of hypothesis, research hypothesis, statistical hypothesis, operational hypothesis, and et cetera, et cetera. So, all right, don't worry about it. At the moment, you just understand that whenever you have formulated hypothesis in the null form, then you are only using the two-tail test. And when you formulate hypothesis in the directional form, then you have to use one-tail test. And when you say one-tail and two-tail, only the standard values which are given in the tables, they differ. All right. And more, if you are so keen, attend my other series of lecture, which we will have, and you will understand. All right. Next question. How can you calculate DF in multiple correlation? I have already shown you ANOVA. This ANOVA is giving you the correlation, that the DF. Okay, so this DF in multiple correlation, you have to take it from the ANOVA, which was there, the table below. Or if you see that the multiple correlation towards the end, the DF was given. All right, another is question is, kindly name some books which will be helpful to us. All right, I will tell you the name of the books. So I will go to the Word file and I will write the name of the books, or if you can note it down, I will be grateful. You can note down. One of the book is, but let me tell you, dear friends, not even single book gives you the way I am teaching. Because no book takes the objective, no book writes the hypothesis, no author takes the data, analyze the data, write, take the output, use it for interpretation. They do not do it. It is only in one book. Actually, I should not say, but since you are forcing me, I have written a book, and the name of the book is Research Methodology and Applied Statistics. I repeat, Research Methodology and Applied Statistics by D.N. Sansanwal. And you can get it on Flipkart or Amazon also. And the publisher is Shipra Publications in Delhi. Shipra, S-H-I-P-R-A, Shipra Publications, P-U-B-L-I-C-A-T-I-O-N-S, Delhi. So Shipra Publication. So you can get it from Amazon, no problem. There are many examples are given, okay, along with interpretation, etc. All right. Next question, let us see. Sir, please tell whether the wording of my objective is correct or not. To study the joint contribution of educational aspirations, study habits, and school climate in predicting academic anxiety of secondary school male and female students separately. Instead of secondary schools, you should, in fact, if you are so keen, this will be part of your title. You can only say male and female students separately, because whether they are class 9th student, 10th students, 6th class students, government schools, or that will be the part of your title. Otherwise, you are excellent. You have understood, Aman. Thank you very much. Only the correction you have understood. Do not write secondary school, because this will be the part of the title. Very good, Anam. Very nice. All right. Let me see another one. In joint contribution, while we were reporting, is there any need to write individual contribution? My dear friend, tomorrow I will tell you the individual contribution. And I will tell you how to establish the regression equation for prediction purposes. That is the part and parcel of regression equation, regression analysis. Today, I was only to talk about multiple correlation. And fortunately or unfortunately, the calculation is along with the regression analysis. So this I will take tomorrow. Do not worry about it. All right. Next question, let us see. Sir, you are really correct. Not even single book gives us such useful information. Thank you very much for the kind words. Let me see another question. I am very happy you are asking so many questions. Sir, thank you very much. All right, let us see another one. So how to do missing value analysis in SPSS? My dear friend, those values which are missing, the size of the sample will reduce. And there are many situations in which you cannot have missing. If you have missing, then you can, in place of those missing values, you can substitute the average values there. So therefore, this can be taken care of. Nothing to worry. I will show you also. All right. To study the joint contribution of technological readiness, attitude, infrastructure readiness, and resource readiness in predicting e-learning. No, my dear friend. See, technology readiness, is it a continuous variable or is it a discontinuous variable? Your attitude is okay. Infrastructure readiness. So technology readiness is not your continuous variable. Infrastructure readiness is not your continuous variable. Resources readiness is not your continuous variable. So therefore, you cannot use the multiple correlation. No, this is not correct. I have told you in the beginning that whatever variable you are considering for the multiple correlation, all variables must be continuous. If you have, I had male and female discontinuous variable, so I did the analysis separately for them. Okay, so Vijay, please again think about these variables and my observation on it. All right, next question, let us see. Sir, what is effect size? I will show you. Don't bother this effect size to that extent. Okay. Sir, but I measured using a Likert scale. Number one, my dear friend, if you have developed a Likert scale, then Likert scale will only give you the reaction. It will not tell you the readiness. So I'm not very sure what type of items you wrote. Okay. So therefore, depending upon that, if you share your items, then I will tell you the correct name of that. Then it should be reaction towards technology facilities. or I can better word it if you tell me your the tools. All right, let us see. The output in multiple correlation table are at the bottom, one-tailed test is written, but we interpret two-tailed test because I had written or formulated hypothesis in the null form. Whenever you formulate hypothesis in the null form, then you have to analyze it with the help of two-tailed test. Okay. Sir, how to check normality of data? Okay. I have told you how many times you have a data, you can use SPSS and you can calculate the kurtosis. Okay, tomorrow I can take the data and I will demonstrate it to you. Nothing to worry about it. Okay. So thank you very much, dear friends. If there are no other questions, I'm grateful for your participation. So thank you very much. I am going out now. Shubham.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Shubham.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you.
I'm going out now. All right.
Okay, sir.